it's Carol. I'm back in my art room tonight. And I want to do a video with the black background and a red and white string pour. So I'm just spreading my black paint. Better get my other glove on. Just trying to get it evenly covered. Forgot to tape the back. Hopefully I'm not going to be doing too much chipping, so should be okay. I'll get the sides done. Okay, that should be good. Okay. First, I'm going to try. I just hope this isn't too thick. Okay. My red and my white. I hope you can see. I've got some thin crochet thread. I'm going to put the one in the red. I hope I can get this to work. I did a trial earlier. So I need to get the other end in there. White. I'm going for two colors in one, see what happens. I need some more white paint. This is thin, so it's pretty finicky to work with. Pull them out together. Get this one untangled. Oh, Oh. Don't tell me I have a knot. Oh, dear. Well, that's not going to work. Well, I'm just going to leave the knot in. Okay, let's try this again. One end and one end. You can't see. Doesn't look like I have a lot of red on there. Let's try pulling. Wow, that's different. Looks like this pulled a lot of paint from the canvas. Just gonna lay this down in here and try and put some paint back on there. I'm surprised because that wasn't a lot, a heavy string either. That's okay. We can always touch that up later. Same with the red here. All right, now I'm just going to do a red one. It's a messy job. Maybe my black is too thin. I'm not sure. The white came out nice. Maybe my red is too thick. I did this little one earlier. The red came out really nice. We'll see. See what happens. Well, I'm going to do another red one because I like it. I like the red. Okay, let's try this one. It's like a one-sided flower. Get another piece of string. Yeah, put some more red. Nice. That's pretty good. Cut this in half. I'm using the other half. I think I'm gonna try this white one. Some more in the white, on the white. Okay. Well, it looks like we're not going to have a two-tone flower. I was trying to go for the red and white together, but I haven't figured that one out yet. Maybe on my next video. Pretty soon, I'm going to start doing something different. But I seem to go back to these all the time. Well, it looks nice with the black going through it. You can see that. I'm gonna. I just want one more. I don't know whether. I was gonna try and fix, or not fix it, but. Add a little more white to this one. There. There! I like it. feel like I want to keep going, but I don't know. I should put any little red ones at the bottom. No, I think I'm gonna leave it. I'll hold it up so you can see. I like it. Well, it's better than the last time I did a red one, because it didn't come out very well. The red just disappeared into the black, but this is a different paint that I'm using, and maybe it's a little thicker. So, good. I'm glad this turned out. Thanks for watching. Hope you subscribe to my channel and come back. Hit the like button and the bell. Thank you. Okay, it's Carol, and I'm back to show you guys what my dried paintings are like and show you how they turned out. So this one here is on a canvas. Dried really good. Canvas paintings dry so super smooth. This is just a little one I did on a piece of cardboard just to practice. This one I did maybe a week ago, and it's very smooth, pretty smooth. It's on a wood board, and it's pretty smooth, dried okay. And then this one I did after that one, similar colors. And this one has more black showing, and it dried pretty good too. So it looks pretty much how it did when it was wet. This only has silicone in the background. Same with this one. So it has to be cleaned off really well before I varnish it. This doesn't have any silicone in it. Okay, and that's the update. Thanks for watching.